for ICBMs, the single most important role that they play, in my view, is as a hedge against a problem in one of the other legs, particularly in the submarine leg. Without a substantial number of ICBMs in the United States, if we had some problem, a technical problem or a vulnerability because of any submarine warfare of a potential adversary with our submarines, we'd be left with an adversary having to undertake an attack involving only a handful of aim points in order to take out our deterrent. So having that as those ICBMs to avoid that even unlikely scenario is a worthwhile investment.
Do we need not replace the whole triad? And in particular, I would not build a new ICBM. I would let the present ICBM force phase out as it ages. We have quite an adequate deterrence with just the submarine forces. And in fact, no one has ever developed a way of detecting submarines at sea or with any reliability or constancy. And therefore, I think we can have very high confidence in our submarine force. So I just don't buy that argument, basically.
But what about air-launched cruise missiles? Do we need nuclear air-launched cruise missiles as well as land-based missiles, as well as submarine missiles, as well as bombs that can be dropped from planes?
What the air-launched cruise missiles provide as we go forward with the long-range strike bomber, with the new stealthy bomber, which should be able to penetrate even advanced air defenses for a period of time, what having air-launched cruise missiles for that system will provide is a hedge against the possibility that air defenses become more capable sooner than we expect, and then the capability to effectively employ both conventional weapons, which is the long-range strike, the so-called LRSO, and nuclear weapons in the face of significant air defenses.
Well, you can have belts and suspenders, and then belts and suspenders for the belts and suspenders, and that's what we're getting into here. We have a stealth bomber force. The bomber force itself is not really necessary for deterrence. The main part of a deterrence lies with the submarine force, the Trident missiles that are fired from the Trident submarines. They are essentially invulnerable to attack. They do not require a launch on warning problem. They don't have a launch on warning problem with them. And so I start off by saying the deterrence is really accomplished with the submarine force. If we add a bomber force to that, that gives us extra insurance. But also, I think more importantly, it gives us a dual capable system, since the bombers, the B-2, for example, has been used many times for the dropping of conventional bombs. It's a very good vehicle for that purpose.
Well, so what would a smart version of the triad look like in the future, one that is affordable, still provides the options you have, but doesn't pay for a lot of overkill? What would that look like?
Look a lot like the triad that we have today, and continuing to reduce numbers over time. Continue to reduce the numbers within each leg. That's sustainable over time, and it's an investment that our country can afford, and it's an investment in deterrence and strategic stability that really we can't afford not to make.
I just want to emphasize again that in the case of the ICBM, although in many ways it's probably cheaper per warhead than the submarine force, it does have this danger associated with it of opening us up to the susceptibility of an accidental war through a false alarm. And therefore, that's reason enough, I think, to phase it out, recognizing that you have more than enough capability in warheads in the submarine force, and the added assurance you have in the bomber force.